And now, the continuing story of Another World.
Maybe a little.
Would you have some time for some coffee with me?
No, I don't think I have that much time.
Are you sure? That's not fair.
Well,
Alvaro took your bags upstairs, Mr. Corey.
Thank you, Vivian. I'll change first, but I'll unpack this evening, I think.
No, it's all right. I'll unpack for you.
You don't have to do that.
Did you have a nice time on your trip?
We had an exceptional time, Vivian.
Was it a nice country inn?
Oh, yes. Beam ceilings, fireplaces, everything.
Everything we wanted.
Sounds real nice.
Would you ask Alvaro to bring my car around in about 20 minutes, I'd say?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Vivian. Vivian?
Yes, sir.
Anything else?
No, sir.
What's the matter with her this morning?
I don't know.
I expected to get an instant bulletin on the Corey Poultry Farm the minute we walked in.
Did I tell you what a wonderful time I had?
No, but I had a wonderful time, too, so I know.
Can't we just go away somewhere and never come back ever again?
Wouldn't that be lovely? My, how escapist we're being.
I don't think you realize how much fun it was to have you all to myself.
About as much fun as it was for me to have you all to myself.
No phones, no visitors.
I'm very tempted not to go to work.
Do you have to?
I think I should. I think that ought to hold me a while.
Any last-minute instructions for that daughter of yours?
You tell her I said mind her mother. I'll say goodbye.
Mrs. Corey?
What is it, Vivian?
Oh, Mrs. Corey.
What's wrong?
Mitch Blake was here yesterday.
He was?
Yes, ma'am. And your mother, Ada, told me to tell you about that as soon as you came home, but not to tell Mr. Corey.
She said that?
Yes, ma'am.
Did she say why?
No. No, she didn't say.
Well, I can't think of what it would be about. I'm sure it's not very important.
Maybe you better call her.
Yes, I will, Vivian. I'll call her in a few minutes. Listen, Vivian said that Mitch had come over yesterday, and she sounded...
Now, listen, I have to talk to you.
Well, yeah, I know. That's why I called.
Well, I can't go into it on the phone. How soon can you get over here?
Mom, I just got home.
Okay, I'll come over. Just tell me what it's about.
Well, it's Mitch. Now, I think he's out of control.
What time did you get in last night?
I called about 7 o'clock, and Mary said you hadn't arrived.
Oh, I know, Del. I would have called you back, except it was much too late.
I thought you were taking an earlier flight.
Yes, well, I was going to, but when I realized that Kit and Joey were going to be there, I changed my reservations.
And how were Kit and Joey?
Oh, Kit and Joey were fine. Of course, Kit was absolutely so excited that Joey would finally meet her mother.
Kit hasn't seen Ellen herself in some time.
No, I know. And it was a good day that Ellen was having, thank goodness, because it really relieved Kit.
Oh, that's good. She reacted well then.
Yes, Ellen seemed quite happy. It was Joey. It was so somber.
Somber in what way?
Oh, somber. Just somber in general. For instance, last night we went to the yacht club for dinner with the Simons. And, Dee Dee McMillan was there. You remember her? She was wonderful friends with Kit in school, so she and Kit were laughing and reminiscing, and Joey just couldn't hold his own at all.
Did he at least make an effort?
Well, he spoke when he was spoken to, the usual thing. I don't know. So, darling, have you been keeping yourself busy since I've been visiting my sister?
Yes, I have. Fairly busy. Miranda, I'd like your advice on something.
Well, then you shall have it.
Do you remember that tall, good-looking fellow that came with Clarice and Larry to your party just before you?
Jerry Grove.
That's him.
Why?
Well, Amy started seeing him.
I'm not surprised.
Why do you say that?
Because they spent a lot of time together that evening.
And I hope she's not leading him on. You know Amy. To her, the whole world and life is just a big game, and she wants to see how many times she can score.
Oh, Taylor, I get the feeling that Jerry Grove can probably take care of himself.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that.
I wouldn't be at all surprised if that young man has been around a little bit.
Well, yes, but I understand that he and his wife have separated recently. Well, I'd hate to see Amy take advantage of the situation.
Well, he and Amy are going through the same thing. Possibly she can help him.
I must say, I really don't see Amy in the role of a guidance counselor.
You're right. No, I don't either. Would you feel better if I spoke to Amy for you?
Would you? I'd appreciate it.
Yes, of course.
You know, she doesn't always listen to me. And I just think it's funny that a man can have two daughters who are so completely different.
Well, you know, Taylor, they're really not that different. You should have seen Kit Newport. It was really that old kid coming back again.
Yeah. I'm glad to see that Ellen is improving anyway.
So am I.
Must have been easier for you to be with her now that you and I don't have such an involved emotional relationship.
Oh, yes, it was incredibly easy.
All right, so tell me more about Jerry Grove. Well, there's really not much to tell.
Well, you haven't told me anything yet, so we still have plenty of ground to cover.
Well, we're seeing each other.
How many times a week? Once, twice?
Oh, a couple times a week.
So you're an item, so to speak.
You might say that.
Oh. Where do you go on your dates?
You forget, he's a struggling law student. We don't go out.
So what are you telling me? You just go back to your hotel suite and talk?
We talk sometimes.
Oh, come on, Amy. You're teasing me.
No, Cecile, I'm not. Look, if I knew where I stood with Jerry, I would tell you. But it's very hard to tell you when I don't know myself.
He's very handsome.
Yes, that he is.
You know, I still can't understand how Blaine ever managed to land him in the first place. You know, I must say, though, that she's not the same girl she was when she married Jamie. She seems to have changed.
In what way?
Well, I've watched her at the arena. She seems much more sure of herself these days.
Well, she better be if she's hanging around with that crowd.
You mean the people that run the arena?
Yeah, I imagine they're a pretty shady lot, don't you?
Oh, I don't know. It just fascinates me. You know, and I think that it would be very fascinating for our readers, too, if we did a feature about it for Brava.
Well, I must admit I've never seen a casino quite like it, and I've seen my share.
What do you think would be a good hook for the story?
Oh, just do an article on gambling.
Oh, Amy, no. Every good story has to have an angle.
Hi, Liz.
No, that's all right. We were just talking about some things. Come on in.
I'd like to talk to you for a moment alone.
I have to go back to my desk anyway. Look, I'll drop by those notes for the Big Sur fashion layout for you to look at later, okay?
All right. I'm sorry if I'm driving you away.
No, it's all right, really.
Let me know if you come up with any ideas for the arena.
Okay, I will.
Well, I guess I shouldn't have just barged in your office like that.
Oh, that's okay, Liz. What can I do for you?
Well, I just got a call from Pat, and I'm very confused.
Oh, is she back in Bay City?
No, she's in Chicago. She and Alice just got back from their trip.
Oh, well, what did she have to say?
She told me she has no intention of returning to Brava.
Oh, did she give you any explanation?
She didn't elaborate. Now, why would she change her mind so suddenly?
I don't know, Liz.
Well, I asked her why, and she said she'd discuss it with Mac.
Mac?
Yeah, she's probably talking to him on the phone right this minute. Now, what does all this mean?
Liz, I'm just as confused as you are. Excuse me.
Yes? Yes, all right.
Well, who was it?
Thelma. She said that Mac's calling a staff meeting in about 15 minutes.
Do you know what he wants?
She didn't say.
I'm sure he's going to announce that you are now officially editor-in-chief of Bravo.
Mary, we are really
going to have to reorganize this linen closet soon.
Well, I have time today.
No, because I don't. And oh. I must help you. A lot of those linens just have to be thrown out. But I tell you what you can do today is the silver.
Oh, okay. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, also, the kitchen drawers must be cleaned out. They are in such a jumble, I can't find anything.
Oh, that reminds me, Mrs. Bishop. Last week, I found a tape in the tea canister.
You found a what in the where?
A tape in the tea canister.
A tape?
Yeah, I showed it to Mrs. Perini, your niece, and she said that she'd ask you about it.
Where is this tape?
I think she put it in the drawer over here. Oh, yeah, here it is.
How strange. Where did you say you found it?
In the tea canister.
Oh, Mary, we must go through this house thoroughly. Looks like a dictaphone tape.
What?
A dictaphone tape, Mary. That's something they use to dictate. I bet I know who it belongs to. I bet it belongs to Mr. Corey, who used to live here.
Well, should I go call him?
No, that's quite all right. I'm going over the complex anyway today, so I'll just drop it off.
Oh. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, and now, Mary, please, would you call the groceries? Because we have not had any groceries, and I'm going to have toast for dinner because the only thing that's in the refrigerator is one loaf of bread.
Yes, ma'am. I'll call right away.
Thank you, Mary.
Vivian say anything to Mac about Mitch coming to the house?
No, you told her not to.
Yeah, well, now Vivian's gonna wonder what's going on. Never stops, does it?
So what has upset Mitch?
Well, what always upsets him? He feels like you're putting him off.
I was out of town.
Well, I know that, and you know that, but Mitch doesn't know that. I'm telling you, I think there's a screw loose with him someplace. I mean, he called you twice yesterday before he showed up at your house.
Did Vivian tell you that?
No, Mitch told me that. Why didn't you call him, Rachel?
I didn't know he'd call. Vivian didn't get a chance to tell me.
Well, it would have made things much simpler if you had.
Besides, I couldn't have called him. Mac was still at the house. I thought Charlie talked to him.
He did.
Well, didn't that have any effect on him?
Well, yeah, it had an effect on him, but not the effect Charlie thought it would.
Well, what did Charlie tell him?
Well, he said that you and Mac couldn't be happier. And that if Mitch wanted the baby to be happy, that he should step out of the picture once and for all.
And Mitch refused?
Well, not exactly.
Well, what did he say?
He said he wasn't a good enough person to make that kind of a sacrifice. And then he told me that if he put his mind to it, he could give you the same kind of life that Mac has.
What?
Yeah, well, he has this nutty idea that you married Mac only for his money, and that's the only reason you're hanging on to him.
That doesn't even deserve to be answered.
Rachel, would you go to Mac, please, and tell him everything?
Mom, we've been through this before. I can't do that to Mac. I can't destroy his happiness that way.
So you'll destroy your own instead?
I won't let it get to that.
Okay. I've done everything I can.
So, Mitch thinks I just married Mac for his money, huh?
Well, I don't know what he thinks, but that's what he said.
Guess I can't really blame him.
Well, I can.
No, he's not just talking about Mac's money. He's talking about everything Mac can give me. Security, home, children.
Well, sure you want those things. Who doesn't?
Yeah, but he knows where I've come from. He knows how much it meant to me to marry somebody like Mac.
You love Mac.
I'd love him even if he were broke.
Yeah, but Mitch doesn't know that.
So, I gotta make him see it, don't I?
Make him see it how?
By showing him how happy Mac and I are.
Rachel.
It's the only way.
You got something on your mind. I want to know what it is.
I told you you'd try to talk me out of it.
Hello there. Sorry to interrupt your work with a spur-of-the-moment meeting.
Oh, that's all right.
We figured it was important. It is. Please sit down. Well, as you all know from the beginning, I've hoped that Pat's temporary leave of absence would be just that, temporary.
Yes, well, we've all hoped for that, Mac.
And it has nothing to do with you, Cecile, or your abilities.
Oh, I think Cecile understands that.
You've done an excellent job with the magazine, but Pat has been with it since its inception. She was also with the firm before that. So I was very much hoping that she'd retract her resignation.
Have you spoken to Pat?
Yes, she called me just a few minutes ago.
Oh, how is she?
She seems well.
Did she talk about Bravo?
Yes, that was the reason for her call. There's something I don't understand, Cecile, and I'm hoping that you will explain it.
If I can, Mac.
It's really very difficult for me to go into this.
What is it?
You mustn't think of this as an accusation. I simply need information. Pat tells me that she saw you shortly before she left Bay City.
Oh?
And apparently she told you that she had no intention of returning to her job as editor-in-chief of Bravo.
She said that?
Yes, she also said that she left a letter addressed to me with you.
A letter?
So obviously there seems to have been some kind of misunderstanding somewhere, and I'd like for you to clarify it.
Cecile, you never mentioned a letter to me.
No, I didn't.
Well, was there a letter?
I don't know what to say, Mac.
Well, you could try yes or no, Cecile.
I'm sorry to face you with this so bluntly, but Pat's call leaves me no alternative. Philip, I believe that you saw Pat frequently before she left.
Yes, I did.
Did she discuss this matter with you?
Oh, yes, I know all about the letter.
Cecile, I would like to hear what you have to say about it. You won't say anything in your defense? Philip. Did Pat tell you that she had written a letter to me?
Yes, she did. And it's exactly as she said it was. Everything in it was her reason for not coming back to Bravo.
Did she tell you that she gave the letter to Cecile?
Yes, she gave it to Cecile to read. She was supposed to read it and send it back to you.
Well, I never got the letter. I'd like an explanation.
And now, the next part of Another World.
I don't want to explain it, Mac.
Cecile.
You don't want to, or you can't?
I don't want to.
Why is that?
I can't say.
I wish you could.
I've got to leave.
Cecile, I'm very willing to give you the benefit of the doubt.
I can't say anything more.
But why is that?
I just wish you wouldn't ask me.
Perhaps the two of us should discuss it alone. I'll be glad to ask.
It wouldn't matter.
Cecile, Mac is just trying to help you.
He can't.
Well, he might if you give him a chance.
It's just is not fair.
What isn't fair about it?
For me to be under all this pressure.
What kind of pressure are you talking about?
I just can't protect Pat anymore. I can't. I just want out of all of it.
Wait, Cecile.
Matt, please, don't make me do this.
What do you mean that you can't protect Pat?
I've already said too much.
If there's some problem here, I must know it.
Cecile.
Philip,
don't.
You're trying to protect her, too.
Look, I've got to know what's going on here. Now, somebody's got to tell me. Philip? Then it's got to be you, Cecile.
Yes, Pat did come to see me.
When?
The evening after she came here to see you in your office.
What did she want?
I'm not sure.
She didn't say.
She was drunk, Mac. Terribly drunk.
Did she talk to you about returning to Brava?
Oh, she talked about a lot of things. But she didn't make any sense. She just kept rambling on and on. Oh, Matt, I didn't know what to do.
Did she give you a letter?
There was no letter. Oh, perhaps she thought she wrote one, or maybe she did write one and she lost it for all I know. I don't know, but all I know is that she didn't give me a letter.
She didn't mention a letter to you?
No. No, Mac, not a word.
Well, I'm sorry, Cecile. I didn't know that you had to deal with Pat drinking.
You had no way of knowing.
You should have come to me immediately.
Oh, I couldn't.
It would have been better for everyone concerned.
Pat has so many friends here, Mac.
Well, so have you. You must know that. All right, you say when Pat came to see you, she had been drinking.
Yes.
And you don't know why she came to see you?
No.
Well, you two have had a lot of problems in the past. Was she there trying to harass you or something?
I don't know what she was trying to do, Mac.
Cecile, you're not telling...
Philip, you know, you just don't know what I've been through, what it's been like.
Philip, if you knew about this, I do wish you had come and told me.
Look, Pat's drinking problem is nothing like Cecile makes it sound.
Well, I've seen Pat tight several times myself, once here in this office. Otherwise, I'd be too shocked to believe what Cecile has told us.
Then you understand how I felt?
I understand that you didn't want to talk about Pat's drinking, but you must also understand that Pat has been under a terrible strain.
Wait, what kind of strain?
She has a very difficult personal problem. Obviously, she's not able to cope with it.
What kind of problem?
Well, I can't say that, but I think Cecile knows what I'm talking about.
Yes, I do.
I assume that is the reason, taking that into consideration, that you didn't come to me.
That's right. But now I realize that I made a mistake. Pat needs all of our help.
That's true. Cecile, are you willing to trust my decision about this now?
Yes.
We must all consider this episode closed. Since Pat adamantly refuses to come back to Brava, you're the editor-in-chief. I'm going to try to make sure Pat is all right when she returns to her family and her friends.
Miranda! What are you doing here?
Ah, I have come to see you.
When did you get back?
Late last night.
How's Mother?
Oh, your mother is a little better, I'm glad to say.
Oh, good. Kit and Joey must be there by now.
Yes, they got there yesterday evening.
So you stayed to help with the transition?
I tried, Amy.
And what does Joey think of our summer place?
Made him very uncomfortable.
I can imagine. Did he get along with Mother?
Yes, when she could remember who he is.
I thought you said she was better.
Well, Amy, darling, your mother's mental health is very fragile. That's why I tried to really stay on innocuous subjects with her.
Such as what?
Such as what we used to do when we were young and the people we used to know and the places we used to go. She's really living in the past. And I think it's about time you paid her a visit.
Well, I wish I didn't have so much work to do here at Brava. Besides, she's just as happy having Kit there. She always has been.
Now, Amy, she speaks very fondly of both of you.
Is that what you came here for? To chastise me for not being a better daughter?
No, 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 no. Of course not.
Come to think of it, why did you come by?
I came by to speak to my dear niece and tell her all the gossip from Newport.
Yes, well, that was very thoughtful of you.
Yeah. And as a matter of fact, I really should go and see Rick at the research lab and do the same thing with him.
Oh, you haven't talked to him yet?
No, I haven't. But tell me, how are you?
Well, I'm happy to say that I am enjoying myself for a change.
Yes, and I understand there's been a few changes.
So that's it.
What? What's it?
Dad sent you.
Oh, I may have mentioned that I was going to see you today.
And did he just happen to mention that I was seeing Jerry Grove?
Yes, he said something like Brad was out and this struggling young law student was in.
So he sent you by to talk to me about it.
Do you mind terribly?
Miranda, what would you think if I told you that I like Jerry a lot?
I wouldn't believe you. Because he's not your type.
Maybe that's why I like him, because he's different.
Now, that I'd believe.
He's also very good-looking and, at the moment, very handy.
And also very married, I understand.
He's in the process of getting a divorce.
Well, your father is very concerned.
For me or for Jerry?
Both of you.
Well, look, as far as I'm concerned, I am a step up for Jerry. So you and Dad had best just turn your concern in another direction.
All right, Amy, I have done my duty, and I can see that I just can't turn you around.
I will tell Dad that you gave it the old college try, okay?
Thank you very much.
Are you free for lunch today?
No, darling, I'm sorry, I'm not.
Oh, why, are you going by to see Rick?
Well, yes, but I did think, I thought possibly I'd stop in and say hello to Mac while I was in the complex.
Oh, I didn't realize you knew Mac that well.
Where you been?
Mac and I took a man down a little trip.
I wish you wouldn't do that. Disappear without saying anything.
Vivian knew where we were.
I called yesterday twice. She said you were busy.
I was busy.
Too busy to call?
I didn't know you'd called.
She didn't tell you?
I couldn't have called back anyway. Mac was home.
I don't like not being able to get in touch with you.
We're gonna have to get used to that.
Well, I'm not going to get used to it.
Please, Mitch, you've got to be reasonable.
I have been.
By showing up on my doorstep and asking Vivian all sorts of questions about me, what was she supposed to think?
I had no choice.
You could have waited until I returned your calls.
Well, I was in no mood to wait after you sent Charlie over to tell me to clear out of your life.
You were wrong what you said about me.
Was I?
Yes, you were.
Doesn't seem that way to me.
I know it doesn't. But I didn't marry Mac for what he could give me.
You told me yourself about your background and about all the things you never had. Mac's wealthy. He's a prominent man.
All I want from Mac is his love and affection.
Well, I don't believe that.
You don't have to believe it, but it's true.
Rachel, I can give you those things.
No, Mitch.
If I put my mind to it, I can do it.
What do I have to do to make you see that I love my husband?
When I first met you, you were divorced from him. You didn't love him then.
Oh, yes, I did. I loved him very much.
He was married to Janice.
Doesn't mean that I didn't still have those feelings for him.
Listen, I know the story. You're the reason why he went off with her.
Yes,
in the
that's
first
true,
place.
Because I loved him too much, and I was jealous, and I didn't have any reason to be.
There was a reason.
No, that came later, because I was too stubborn to admit that I'd been wrong.
All the time you were seeing me, you never once mentioned that you cared for Matt.
Doesn't mean those feelings weren't there.
I never saw them.
You saw only what you wanted to see?
No.
Mitch, haven't you stopped to ask yourself why we only came so close and then I pull away?
Because you were reluctant to get involved again. I can understand that.
No, no, it was because I was still too involved with Mac.
Well, if you cared for him, why didn't you fight for him?
That's exactly what I did do.
While you were seeing me?
I used you, Mitch.
Don't say it.
Look, I know it's not flattering to either of us, but it's true. That's why I couldn't tell you I cared for Mac.
If you lied then, how do I know you're not lying to me now?
Because you know I'm not.
How do I know that you're not trying to turn me against you?
I'm not. I just want you to see that Mac and I are happy.
Well, I don't see it. Mac, maybe, yes. But you, no. I don't see that. Every time I see you, you almost jump out of your skin.
Look, if I'm not happy now, it's because you haven't given me a moment's peace since we got back from St. Croix.
You're carrying my child. What am I supposed to do? Vanish from the face of the earth?
Look, if I could convince you that Mac and I are happy, would that make any difference at all to you?
You can't convince me.
If I could.
I'd have to see it to believe it.
All right, then you'll see it.
What are you driving at?
I'm having some people over at the end of the week. Would you come over? Spend the evening with us?
Mac's gonna be there?
Of course he's gonna be there.
Now what is this supposed to prove?
I just want you to see us together, to see for yourself that what I'm telling you is true.
Rachel, it's not gonna work.
All I'm asking you to do is to be there.
You're out of your mind.
Maybe I am. Desperation makes people do strange things. I want you to see us together as a family. I want you to see what you would destroy if you were to tell Mac the truth. Are you afraid?
No, I'm not afraid.
Then will you be there?
When?
I'll call you. I'll tell you when I know when it's going to be.
I'm not interested in hearing your critique.
Well, you're going to hear me right now.
Look, why don't you just save your breath and put yourself in my shoes for a moment? What would you have done?
You mean if I were you as you? Or just a normal human being?
If you were me, just as I'm standing in front of you now.
As you? I suppose I would have gone on the attack.
Don't think that I enjoyed myself.
Cecile, you've done everything you can to undermine Pat's credibility. It must have felt fantastic for you to finish off the job.
What I said in there was the truth.
The truth is you see it.
It's true. Pat was drunk when she came to see me.
That may be true. But tell me, what about the letter?
There was no letter.
Oh, it isn't enough, is it? It isn't enough for you that you got her out of the way. Now you have to destroy and shred every bit of decency that people feel for her here.
She's not coming back to work. So what difference does it make?
It makes a difference to me.
Yes. I've noticed how chummy the two of you have been lately.
Listen to me, Cecile. Pat needs help right now.
Mm-hmm. And you're very good with older ladies in distress. But unfortunately for Pat, she's not as rich as some of your former clients.
I don't care what you say about me, but you just leave Pat out of here. You understand that? She's done nothing to hurt you.
She talked to Mac, didn't she?
It's all going to catch up with you, Cecile. Just wait. One of these days, it's going to catch you.
Not if I keep moving and I don't look back.
And you're going to have to move very fast.
Well, I'm dueling quite well, don't you think?
Do you really think Mac's a dummy? You don't think that he's going to catch on to you sooner or later?
Mac wasn't even surprised when I told him that Pat was drunk when she came to see me.
Yes. And you counted on that, didn't you?
As you said, Pat's credibility has been destroyed. She can't turn Mac against me now.
Maybe she can't. But just guess who can.
Oh, well, I can handle you.
With more stunts like the one you pulled with Jasper Dunning?
I don't even know Jasper Dunning.
No, but Amy does.
Look, the fact that Dunning asked for a new editor is between you and Mac. I really don't care to be dragged into
it. Well, I'm warning you, Cecile. Don't you ever pull anything like that on me again, do you hear?
And I'm warning you. Don't you get in my way.
You think you've got all your bases covered?
All but one. And if you try to stop me, I'll destroy you just as I destroyed Pat. Everybody already knows what you are. Do you really think that they take your word over mine?
Now, you listen to me carefully. As long as I'm in Bay City, you've got somebody to worry about. And for that matter, Pat is not knocked out of the box yet. Don't ever think that.
Pat wasn't knocked out of the box. She was so drunk, she fell out. Now, if you excuse me, I have work to do. Hello? Why, yes, of course. Put her on. Hi, Joni. Yes, I did get your story suggestions. I think they're wonderful, especially the one on the hot tubs. I think it would be great fun to do an article on it. I've already talked to our editors, and we've got...
You're going to fall, Cecile. And I promise you, when you do, I'll be waiting.
Desirable disturbance than you. I didn't know you were coming in town, and I'm so
well,
glad.
Well, I didn't either, but I had some errands to run. I wanted to show Mom my ring.
Oh, yes.
And I wanted to do some shopping.
So, how was Ada, and how did she like the ring?
Oh, she loved the ring. She's fine.
How's the shopping?
I wanted to get myself some new maternity stuff.
So, do I get a preview?
You got it. This is
wow.
Some of what I bought.
That's
I was hoping
really
you'd like it.
Beautiful. That's silk, isn't it?
Yes,
oh,
it is.
Let me feel it. That's marvelous. I love everything you get into anyway.
Well, now that I've got all these pretty clothes, I need an excuse to show them off. And I was thinking, we haven't entertained in ever so long, and our friends are probably feeling neglected.
You mean somebody's complained?
No, of course not. But they should. I mean, we haven't entertained anybody except Tracy and Ross.
So how do you intend to rectify the situation?
Well, I thought maybe we could have some people over on Friday. What do you think?
I think that'd be fun, as long as you're sure you're up to it.
I am.
So is it going to be a dinner or is it going to be a cocktail party?
Well, I thought we could have a buffet, and then if it's cool enough, we could have some dancing on the terrace.
Oh, terrific. I've already got my partner picked out.
Good.
Who else are you going to invite?
Well, I thought I would invite... Is that for you?
Excuse me, young. Yes, Liz. Miranda Bishop? Well, would you tell her that she'll have to wait, please, Liz?
No, Mac.
Hold on a minute, please, Liz. Darling, I can't send her away without saying something.
No, I mean, send her in.
Rachel, I know that you're not fond of Miranda.
No, we can invite her to the party. We owe her.
Are you certain?
Sure.
Well, all right, if you say so. Sorry, Liz. Would you ask Miranda to come in? Thank you. Well, I'm glad you've gotten over your feelings about her.
Well, I haven't, but I can't prevent them from letting me be sociable.
Good girl.
Mac?
Hello, Miranda.
Hello, Rachel. I didn't know you were here.
Well, I decided I'd surprise Mac.
Well, and a wonderful surprise it was, too.
Isn't that nice? I was just stopping by to speak with Amy about something. I thought I'd come and say hello to you.
How nice of you. You were in Newport, weren't you?
Yes, I was, visiting my sister.
That's Kit's mother?
Yes, it is.
How is she?
Oh, well, I'm afraid she's probably as well as can be expected. I don't think the poor darling really ever got over Kit's kidnapping.
That's so unfortunate.
Miranda, we're having a party on Friday, and we were wondering if you could come.
A party? How nice.
Would you be there?
I guess I'll make a point of it.
Good. We'd like to have Taylor, too, if he's available.
I think he should be here.
Good. I also thought I'd invite Gwen and Clarice and Larry. And Joey and Kit.
Oh, I don't know if Joey and Kit can make it.
Oh, that's too bad. I was hoping to have some young people so that I could entice Jamie to be there.
They're visiting my sister right now in Newport.
Oh, did they go with you?
No, they didn't. As a matter of fact, they arrived just when I was leaving. But maybe they'll be back in time.
I also thought I'd invite Mitch Blake.
Stay tuned for the conclusion of Another World.
Certainly sounds like a lively group.
Rachel, do you think Mitch will fit in with the rest of the crowd?
Well, why shouldn't he?
Well, he really doesn't have any friends among those people.
Well, he knows everybody who's going to be there, Mac. We all frequent the club.
I suppose.
Don't worry. I'll make sure that there are plenty of people for him to talk to. Well, I'll tell you who else is on the guest list as soon as you come home tonight. Okay, I've got to run. I got to get back to the poultry farm. But you know, Miranda, we're starting an egg farm. Nice to see you.
Nice seeing you too, Rachel. Rachel certainly seems like she's in a good mood.
Terrific mood.
Good. Listen, Mac, I must be going too.
Oh, it was so nice of you to stop by.
Well, thank you very much. Oh, Mac.
What's the matter?
I almost forgot. I believe I have something that belongs to you.
What's that?
It's a, I think it's a dictaphone tape. Mary found it in the strangest place while she was cleaning the house the other day.
Oh, you think it's something that belongs to me?
Well, I assume so. Here, I have it in my bag. It's... I had it.
Can't find it?
No. And I know why, because I put it on the table by the door so I wouldn't forget to bring it.
And you forgot to bring
it. And I forgot to bring it. I feel a little silly.
Oh, it doesn't matter. It's not important.
Well, if it does belong to you.
But we're not sure of that, are we?
Well, I don't know who else would have been in that house that was using a dictaphone.
Oh, Brian Bancroft had the house before me, you know, and he uses the dictaphone quite often in his work.
Oh, really? Brian Bank? I never thought of him.
Do you have a dictaphone?
No, I don't, but I suppose I could get one.
Well, that would solve it, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
You could play the tape if you've got a dictaphone to play it on. Then know who it belongs to.
I don't know why I didn't think of that. That's exactly what I will do. I will play that tape.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Another World.